Yes, ma'am.
Good morning. Okay. So you are 9th sem now?
8th and 9th both, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. So topic for today is genetic disorders. So before starting proper genetics, some basics about genetics. So the Gregor John Mendel, he's the father of modern genetics. And why? Because he was the first to demonstrate the mechanism of transmission of characters from one generation to the other. So he was the first who described how the characters are passed from one generation to other. So he is known as father of modern genetics. And Sir Mendel proposed that inheritance is controlled by paired germinal units or factors, and they are now called as genes. Do you want to write? Do you want to write also? Now, genetic information.
Slides now, ma'am.
Yes. You want this previous one?
I didn't know all about it.
Now, genes. So these are the basic unit of genetic information, and genes determine the inherited characters. So the gene is the unit of this genetic information. Genome, this is the collection of genetic information. So collection of gene is known as genome. And chromosome is the storage unit of genes. So chromosome is the place where genes are stored. And DNA, it's a nucleic acid that contains the genetic instructions. So you can see here, this is the chromosome, and this is the gene 1, gene 2, and this is DNA. So DNA contains many genes over it, and chromosome contains DNA. Now, structure of chromosome. So the important things which we must know is the locus and allele. Locus is the location of gene on the chromosome. So here you can see this is the locus. Here a particular gene, A1, A2, is there. And allele is one variant from a form of a gene at a particular locus. So this is the allele is the variant form of a gene at particular locus. So this is locus 1, this is locus 2. Locus 1 contains gene 1. At locus 2, there is gene 2. Now, human genome. So there are 46 chromosomes in human genome, 23 pairs, we all know, out of which 22 pair of chromosomes are called as autosomes, and one pair is sex chromosome. And it is XX in female and XY in male. We all know this. And this is the karyotyping of human chromosome. 23 pair of chromosomes, 22 pairs autosomes, and one pair sex chromosome. Now, genotype and phenotype. Genotype means genetic structure of the individual, and phenotype is the appearance of the individual. So at each locus, there are two genes, and these genes constitute the genotype at the locus. And the expression of genotype is termed as phenotype. For example, phenotype can be hair color, can be weight, or the presence or absence of a disease. So while studying genetic disorders, there are six general patterns of inheritance which we commonly see. So these are autosomal recessive, autosomal dominant, X-linked recessive, X-linked dominant, codominant, and mitochondrial. Now, what is dominant and what is recessive? Dominant versus recessive. So, a dominant allele is expressed even if it is paired with a recessive allele. If there are two alleles and one is dominant, one is recessive, then dominant will express itself. And recessive allele is only visible when paired with another recessive allele. So, for the expression of recessive allele, two alleles are required, but for the dominant, only one allele is required. Here you can see this capital B is for ground, yes? Capital B for ground, small b for gray, B is dominant, small b is this recessive. So here both B are capital, so the cat is brown. Here one dominant gene is there, one dominant allele is there, so this is again brown. And here both recessive alleles are there, then it expressed gray color, small b. Now, autosomal dominant. So here, affected males and female appear in each generation of the pedigree. Here, you can see the inheritance of autosomal dominant. Here, this is the affected father and this is the unaffected mother. And this is the affected gene. Now, in their offspring, this is the son who carried one Y gene from the father. So this is affected. Here, this daughter got the normal gene from the father. This son also got the normal gene from the father. And this daughter got the abnormal gene from the father. So these are affected even though the single gene, single allele is diseased. So for expression of autosomal dominant, only one allele is required. Affected mothers and father transmit the phenotype to both son and daughters. So whosoever is affected of the parents, he or she will transfer the affected allele in their offspring, be it son or daughter. And the example is Hutchinson disease. Are you able to understand?
Yes, ma'am.
So, in autosomal dominant, only single mutant gene is dominant and disease manifests in heterozygous state. Means if only one affected gene is there, that is heterozygous state, then also the disease will manifest. And this is vertical transmission. Abnormal gene is passed from one generation to other. If one of the parents are affected, risk of recurrence is 50% in each pregnancy. So these are the some basics, and after finishing the basics, we'll continue to the disease proper. Downs and Turner is there in your course, and some congenital malformation is also there. Now these are the examples of genetic disorders. So autosomal dominant, the frequent is adult polycystic kidney disease. Then nervous system, neurofibromatosis 1, von Recklinghausen, also NF1, neurofibromatosis 1, tuberous sclerosis and Hutchinson disease. So these are the nervous system disorders which are autosomal dominant. Then in RBCs, in hematology, hereditary spherocytosis, this is also AD. In skeletal system, osteogenesis imperfecta, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, Marfan syndrome, and achondroplasia. So these are all AD, and some malignancies also like familial adenomatous polyposis coli and retinoblastoma. So these are the autosomal dominant conditions. So should I proceed to the next slide?
Yes, ma'am.
So here you can see retinoblastoma. So this is a child with retinoblastoma. Neurofibromatosis. So there are, this is buttonhole sign, axillary freckles, and cafe au lait macules. She is Marfan syndrome. And here you can see Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, over flexible joints. Now the next one is autosomal recessive. So here, two affected alleles are required for the expression of disease. So you see here, the father and mother both are carriers, and in their offspring, one is unaffected, who got both the unaffected alleles from the parents. Then these two children, they got one affected allele from the parents, so they are carriers. And she got the both affected alleles from the parents, so she is affected daughter. And the example is cystic fibrosis. And the disease appears in both male and female children of unaffected parents. So here, both healthy parents carry the same recessive gene. Because they are carriers, so disease doesn't manifest in them. 25% of offsprings are affected in each pregnancy, 50% are carriers, and 25% are normal. And this is a more severe condition, and there occurs early onset of the disease in the affected person. Thank you. So these are the examples of some autosomal recessive disorders in metabolic system: cystic fibrosis, phenylketonuria, galactosemia, homocystinuria, and glycogen storage disease. These are all metabolic and autosomal recessive disorders. Then in hematology, sickle cell and thalassemia, endocrine congenital adrenal hyperplasia in skeletal, alkaptonuria in nervous system, Friedreich's ataxia, and spinal muscular atrophy, SMA. So these are the some examples of autosomal recessive disorders. Now, X-linked inheritance. So different results are obtained from reciprocal crosses between red-eyed and white-eyed drosophila here. This is not that much common, but this can be seen. And why different results are obtained? Because the gene responsible for eye color is X-linked. So here, we don't see the classical pattern of vertical or horizontal transmission. So here you can see more males than females show the disorder. This is the X-linked inheritance. This is the affected father and this is unaffected mother and their offsprings. There are two unaffected son and daughters are carrier. If the reverse case is there, like mother is carrier and father is unaffected, then here we can see two of their offsprings are normal. One is carrier and one is affected. So here, more males than females show the disorders. Daughters are carriers if the father is affected, and none of the son of an affected male show the disorder or carriers. An example is hemophilia. So here, males are said to be hemizygous in respect to X-linked gene because they have only one X. The trait is determined by the gene carried on X chromosome. That's why this is called as X-linked. It manifests in female only when it is in double dose. Therefore, females are rarely affected. A heterozygous female forms a carrier. In males, even single mutant gene on their X chromosome, that is in heterozygous state, are affected. Now some examples: hemophilia A and B, G6PD, color blindness, Bruton, A gamma globinemia, Bischoff-Ehlers syndrome, chronic granulomatous diseases, and diabetes insipidus. So these are the examples of X-linked recessive disorders. Now, X-linked dominant. So here, affected will pass the disorder to all daughters, but to none of their sons. affected heterozygous female married to unaffected males pass the condition to half of their sons and daughters, and example is fragile X syndrome. And examples, this is a very rare condition, and examples are incontinentia pigmenti and X-linked rickets. And it's a very lethal condition, and most of the cases go in abortion. So we can leave this mitochondrial inheritance. This is not a very much huge for you people. Now coming on to the Down syndrome. So this is important from your exam point of view. And this is trisomy 21. This is the most common chromosomal abnormalities, and frequency is 1:600 to 1:800 births. And the incidence increases with the increasing maternal age. Congenital heart disease is the most important factor that determines survival. So there are various abnormalities which are seen in children suffering from Down syndrome, and the most important one is congenital heart disease. If it is severe, then child won't survive for longer duration. So how to diagnose this? So by seeing at a child, we can diagnose it because of the dysmorphic features, which are very much peculiar to Down syndrome. Here you can see depressed nasal bridge, protruded tongue, open mouth, and low-lying eyes, low-set ears. Here you can see low-set ears. So this is below outer canthus. So there can be short stature, hypotonia, mental retardation is there. They are happy children and very much friendly. Tongue is usually protruded. There is brachycephaly, epicanthic fold over the eyes, upslanting of the palpebral fissure. This is upslanting. Then tracheoesophageal fistula can be there, and duodenal atresia, flattened nasal bridge, epicanthal fold, and in eye there is brush pit spots. Their hands are short and broad. There is single palmar crease. Clinodactyly means this incurving of the little finger. loose velvety skin and increased space between first and second toe. Here you can see this. So this is the semen crease, single palmar crease, and small ear with overfolded helix. Ear is small and helix is overfolded. The confirmation is done by karyotyping, in which we see trisomy 21. So you can see here, at 21 number, there are three chromosomes, trisomy is there. Management. So this is done by genetic counseling and antenatal diagnosis for subsequent pregnancies, because there are higher risk of recurrence of Down syndrome. So antenatal counseling and diagnosis is to be done. Stimulation program to be run. Assessment of growth, vision, hearing and behavior of the affected child. Antenatal diagnosis is done by ultrasound and triple test. In ultrasound, there is thick nuchal fold, short femur, congenital heart disease, and GIT anomaly can be observed. In triple test, maternal serum alpha fetoprotein is decreased, maternal unconjugated estriol is decreased, and gonadotropins are increased. The next is Klinefelter syndrome. So this is the most common sex chromosome aneuploidy. Here, 47XXY, and inheritance is sporadic and increases with increased maternal age. The clinical features are frontal baldness, tendency to grow fewer chest hair are less, there is development of breast, female type of pubic hair pattern, small testes, long legs, wide hips, narrow shoulders, and poor beard growth. IQ is less, stature is tall, muscle tone poor, reduced secondary sexual characteristics, gynecomastia and small testes and infertility. So diagnosis is by hormonal assay. The level of testosterone will be low, and in karyotyping, bare bodies will be there. Treatment is hormonal replacement therapy. Now Turner syndrome. So this is a combination of characteristic phenotypic features along with absence of second X chromosome. Karyotype is 45XO. Second X chromosome is not there. You can see webbed neck here, shield-like chest, and winging of scapula. So short stature, low hairline, shield-like chest, widely placed nipples, shortened metacarpal, fourth, small fingernails, there can be brown spots or nevi, characteristic facial features, neck fold, incoarctation of aorta, poor breast development, elbow deformity, rudimentary ovaries, and no mensuration. So these are the clinical features of Turner. So diagnosis is done by hormonal profile, low estradiol, increased FSH and increased LH, karyotyping, and in karyotyping there will be no bar bodies. Treatment is by giving hormone, recombinant growth hormone, and treatment of associated abnormalities, psychological support, and estrogen. This is Patau syndrome, trisomy 13. Cleft lip and palate is also associated with this. Microcephaly and small mouth, small jaw, short neck, shield-like chest, prominent occiput, dysplastic or malformed ear, clenched hands with overlapping of fingers, flexed big toe and prominent heels. These are the clinical features of this syndrome, Patau. Now the birth defects. So birth defect is a problem that occurs when a baby is developing in its utero, and this can be minor or severe. And they may affect appearance of the child, organ function, physical and mental development. So they can affect anything. Here you can see anencephaly. Here various malformations are there. It can be from minor to severe one. So most birth defects are present within the first 3 months of pregnancy, when the period of organogenesis is going on. And some birth defects can be harmless, others require long-term medical treatment. So these are all birth defects: Down syndrome, spina bifida, fetal lung maturity. So causes can be genetic, lifestyle choices and behaviors like consumption of alcohol and cigarette smoking during pregnancy, exposure to certain medication during pregnancy, infections during pregnancy, and a combination of all these factors. But the exact cause is not known. So birth defect can be major, minor, and genetic. Genetic we have dealt with, major and minor. We'll teach in next few slides. So minor defect, that the baby may have a minor birth defect like birthmark, skin tag, extra fingers, or extra toes, cleft lip, cleft palate, or club foot. So these are all the minor birth defects. There is no life-threatening complication with each birth defect. And major ones, the baby may have a major birth defect like spina bifida, meningomyelocele, gastrocnemius, omphalocele, imperforate anus. So these are the major birth defect. This is gastrocnemius, this is omphalocele, this is skin tag, and genetic like Down syndrome, Patau, Klinefelter, Turner, etc. Now, minor birth defects. So, most birthmarks like capillary hemangioma, Mongolian blue spot, they require no special care and may disappear as the baby gets older. And this is skin tag or extra finger. It can be on toes also. They do not have a bony attachment. If the extra digits have a bony attachment, then we should refer to the tertiary hospital. They may have bone attachment, they may not have. If they are not having, then we can tie it and this will fall off when the blood supply is hampered. If it is having a bony attachment, then should be referred to orthopedic specialty to remove it by surgery. Then cleft lip and cleft palate. So, cleft lip is a birth defect which results in unilateral or bilateral opening in the upper lip between the mouth and nose. Cleft palate is the breach in continuity of palate or a furrow in the palatal vault. It is a birth defect characterized by an opening in the roof of the mouth caused by lack of tissue development. And this is one of the most common congenital deformities at the time of birth. Here you can see this is a normal child, this is cleft palate, unilateral, this is bilateral cleft palate, normal palate, this is cleft lip only, here bilateral cleft lips, this is cleft palate, this is cleft lip with partial palatal involvement, and this is bilateral cleft lip with full palatal involvement. Here you can see. These are cleft lips, this is cleft palate. So treatment is providing emotional support and reassurance to the mother and explain the mother that the most important thing to do at this time is to feed the baby for adequate growth until surgery can be performed. If the baby has a cleft lip but the palate is intact, allow the baby to attempt the breastfeed. If the baby breastfeeds successfully and there are no other problems requiring hospitalization, then discharge the baby and follow up in 1 week to check the growth and weight gain of the baby. If the baby cannot breastfeed well because of the cleft, give express breast milk using alternative feeding method. If the baby has a cleft palate, then give express breast milk using once the baby is feeding well and gaining weight, then refer the baby to tertiary hospital or a specialized unit in plastic surgery for the repair of the cleft. So for surgical treatment, there is a rule of 10. Weight should be more than 10 pounds, hemoglobin more than 10, WBC less than 10,000, and age more than 10 weeks. So timing of surgery, more than 10 weeks for this cleft palate. So it can be done by 6 to 12 months. Cleft lip can be done at 6 to 10 weeks. And it's a two-step procedure. So we need not to go in details of surgery. Now the another minor abnormality is club foot. So here this is the normal foot. Here clubfoot, and it describes a range of abnormalities usually which are present at birth in which baby's foot is twisted out of shape or position. And here the tissues connecting the muscles to the bone, that is tendons, are shorter than usual. And it is a very common birth defect. It can be mild or severe. And it can be unilateral or bilateral. Treatment is by providing emotional support to the mother. Then they should be referred to specialized centers within the first month of life, if possible, for the correction of clubfoot. Then coming on to the major birth defects, so spina bifida, meningomyelosis. Here you can see the severity of spina bifida. This is spina bifida occulta. This is very minor condition. This is meningocele and this is myelomeningocele. So spina bifida occulta is the least serious and most common type, usually discovered only on x-rays or scans. And most people never become aware of this condition that they are having. This is spina bifida occulta. Meningocele is the next serious type condition. And here meningocele, the covering of the spinal cord pass back through the opening in the spine to form a cyst-like swelling. And here, if the spinal cord is enclosed in the cyst, the condition is called as myelomeningocele. This is the most serious type of spina bifida. Here only meninges are there, here the spinal cord is also enclosed. Treatment is again providing the emotional support to the mother and family. If defect is not covered by skin, then cover the skin with sterile gauze soaked in normal saline and keep the gauze moist at all the time. Ensure that baby is kept warm and then organize transfer and refer the baby to a tertiary hospital or a specialized center for further evaluation and surgery. And here, this is gastrocchiasis. The intestines are outside of the abdomen through an opening in the abdomen. And this is omphalocele. The intestine, liver, and other organs remain outside the abdomen in a sac. Treatment, again providing support, then establishing IV line and give nothing for only orally, give only IV fluids. And if the defect is not covered by skin, then cover it with a sterile normal saline and keep the baby warm all the time. Insert a gastric tube for free drainage and refer the baby for surgery. This is imperforate anus, agenesis and atresia of the rectum and anus. Etiology is not known and it affects both a male and female child. Treatment is again providing emotional support to the family, giving nothing per orally and establishing IV line. Then insert gastric tube for free drainage, then transfer the baby for surgery. Okay, so this finishes your genetics topic. If you have any doubt, you may ask. Shall I stop now?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.